Hello. I received this parcel from the Hong Kong Nail Store. It contains Matt Shepard's Rua puzzle. Matt Shepard invented and made the original back in 2008. This is a mass-produced unofficial copy, though Matt has said he doesn't mind. However, he would have preferred it if they had called it by its proper name, Rua, instead of the somewhat daft 12-axis dodecahedron. It is a dodecahedron, but most of us would call it a rhombic dodecahedron. Rua, by the way, is Maori for two. Maori are the indigenous Polynesian people of New Zealand. So movement is smooth, but it is a little bit stiff. I'm guessing you could release tensions for that. I think it's been lubed a little bit, but not. It's not like grease or anything, so it's pretty good. You can just scramble it using these like 180 degree turns and keep the shape, which is probably how I would use it. But however, you can turn it to, where is it? You can turn it to there, and then you can carry on making moves. And that, I think, is that like leads to jumbling moves. So for example, you can't then, you know, things kind of become blocked. So it makes it even more, well, it makes it quite difficult. And they're not really sort of puzzles I enjoy, to be honest with you. So I'll probably just do 180 degree moves. I will just do a scramble, but just using 180 degree moves. Yeah, I certainly like the feel of it, so I would definitely recommend it to people. Obviously, I'll leave links to it in my description, and I'll also leave a link to Matt Shepard's YouTube channel. I don't know if he does much nowadays, but I'll put it there anyway. He seems to have been sort of treated a little bit unfairly, to be honest with you, so it's nice to sort of give him a shout out. Right, so in the next video, I'm going to do a full disassembly. But what I do want to do in this video is just do a quick comparison, because I've got a face turning octahedron here, and a lot of the parts are similar. So if I just prize out one of these and one of those, you'll see that those parts are very similar, and the same with the triangles. I'm not going to go into the insides and explain that, because I can't be bothered, but so there are certainly similarities between the different puzzles. But I say in the next video I will take it apart, so stay tuned for that.